Hi, I'm Jackie Schollerman.
And I'm Chase Poole here with the Schollerman Group of Coldwell Banker. And we're here today to discuss a question that we often get from our clients. And it's a difficult one sometimes to approach, but it is, should I go for a 30-year or 15-year mortgage and so forth? There's a lot of different financing options. So they come to us and say, what should I do? What do you think? So my question is, what do you tell them?
Well, depends on the financing condition of that particular buyer.
Certainly.
And if they want to keep their interest rates or, I'm sorry, keep their mortgage payment lower, I would say go with your 30-year fix.
Okay.
But if your finances allows you, and you can certainly change it to a 15-year program. However, when you go to 15-year, you're fixed in that 15 years. So if for some reason your finances changes, you can't really pay less than what you have already
agreed to.
Whereas with 30-year fix, you can keep your monthly mortgage down. However, if you get a bonus or you change your job or you get inheritance or whatever, you can come back and just pay extra to
additional premium payment.
So in essence, you are almost making it like 15-year program. And I've had some clients that they, we just recently sold a home for them, and they went with 10-year ARM, which is basically, it was a 10-year program at a very, very low interest rate. And the buyer knew that in 10 years, they were going to pay the house off. And then because of that, they went with a 10-year program so that on the 11th year, when the interest rate is going to adjust to a higher price, they have already decided that they're going to be paying off the house by then. So it really depends on what your goals are, what your plans are, what your financing conditions are. And one thing that I would like to recommend is that when you close the escrow, ask your lender for amortization schedule, which shows exactly if it's a 30-year or 15-year. You can look every month as to first month, you know, how much the mortgage payment that you're making, how much of that is principal and how much of that is interest.
Absolutely.
And if you decide to pay extra every month, and then you can just come back and say, okay, if I make five payments, that means I'm saving this much interest rate and I'm this much of my money is going to go toward the principal. So the answer to your question is that perhaps consider going with the 30-year fix and then just make extra payments.
What about the length of how long they anticipate living in the home come into play at all?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, if you're planning to be in the house for, let's say, 5 years, and then you may want to go with 5-year ARM. But if you're planning to be there for 15 years or 30 years, and that definitely, the length of the time that you're planning to be in the house, that also one of the determining factors, too.
Absolutely. Well, thank you, Jackie. So if you are thinking of buying or selling, give Jackie or myself a call. We'd love to set up a 15-minute strategy session with you to discuss what is really important to you and whether it's buying or selling. And we'll come up with a customized game plan so that you can get in the game.